welcome to the Archer's Friend production of how to easily make Slim Jim sausages for jerky and for burgers and for whatever else you want. First off, we've purchased a Slim LEM adapter to put on our power grinder. And see all the parts and pieces that come with this. You can make the snack sticks without casings. We're not going to do that. You can make the burger patties, and you can make the jerky wide strips with the adapter plates, but we're not going to do that either. We're going to make some burger patties first. This is going to make the patties kind of like Wendy's. You'll end up with sort of a square, or you can make oblong, or however you want to do it. You'll see what we do. We've previously ground up a bunch of elk meat, and we're going to install that in adapter, and we'll get it going and showing you. First off, I'd like to show you this foot-operated power switch. This is just fantastic when you're using one of these big grinders, and you'll see we've got the tinfoil over our grinder motor to keep drippings from getting into the motor. And as you start feeding this thing, it shoots out onto a piece of paper. That's also part of the adapter package. And you cut it in however size chunks you would like, small, medium, large, king size, whatever. And you see it goes pretty fast. Now this is a lot quicker, faster, easier than those round ones. And you'll never regret if you have a nice power grinder to get one of these attachments and hook it up. It's almost as fast as you can feed it to turn it into a compressed patty. So we stock up our freezer with as many patties as we think we want. We got the butcher paper ready over there with our roll and several pieces already cut, ready for the wrapping project. We just keep making those patties until we got to the amount that we think we're going to be able to handle. And then we take it apart, take off the slide tray, take off the paper roller adapter, and you'll probably have to get you some dowel rods or the end of wooden spoons or something to clean out all these parts and pieces. We're not going to dwell real long time on that because we want to get started with the making of the Slim Jims. And we like to have our Slim Jims inside a casing. And today we're going to be using the collagen casings. Like I say, you have to take this grinder head off, and depending on what you like, we prefer when we're doing this to run the big kidney plate and behind that the cutter blade, and that helps keep things stabilized. The head comes off, you can see it's packed full of meat, so the easiest way I found is to take a spoon handle and stick in there. Those are the adapter plates that come with the system. Pick whatever you like. There's a picture of the big kidney plate that we use, and behind that's the blade. Now we're going to use this nice little gadget that came with our grinder, and what it's for is to make the, I had to pause real quick for a sneeze. What this thing does is it makes the Slim Jims, and it puts it inside a casing. And you notice that long tube there, and inside it was, you saw the little auger blade. And that is critical to getting these little bitty casings stuffed. Otherwise, it's going to drive you nuts, and you'll probably break something trying to force it in there with that the stuffer on the grinder head or the grinder tray. We spray a little silicone, food-grade silicone now. Be sure it's food-grade silicone on everything to make things slide and not stick so much. And we're using these collagens. They're much simpler than the natural casings. They can be stored without refrigeration. Takes a little bit of effort to get it. Usually in the packing and shipping, they'll be crimped a little bit. You stick a finger in there and get it undone and start threading it on this long tube. Now, it's not going to take that whole hank or that whole length, so you just scoot on as many inches as you can possibly get on there, and then you just take a knife or scissors or something and cut that casing tube off, and then you start feeding the previously ground meat through the stuffer, and with some force and effort you run it out there, and then you decide on what kind of length you want. Now I like them to be about 18 inches long, maybe a little bit shorter, and the reason is it eliminates the number of links, and that's about the right size for the smoker that we have, or the smokers that we have, and it makes it easy to lay on the racks without having to break it while you're loading the smoker. And this is also makes it easy to wrap. You also have to think about the width of your butcher paper. And there you can see what we've got. We're going to package her up. We'll freeze it, and then when we need a batch, we'll start smoking it. Thank you for watching. See you in the mountains. Please visit the site.